And the punishment, namely, the prescribed, legal, punishment for fornication that is established upon his testimony, shall be averted from her if she testify, swearing, by God four times that he is indeed lying, in accusing her of having fornicated. And a fifth time that God's wrath shall be upon her if he were being truthful, therein.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
سورة أنزلناها وفرضناها وأنزلنا فيها آيات بينات لعلكم تذكرون الزانية والزاني فاجلدوا كل واحد منهما مئة جلدة ولا تأخذكم بهما رأفة في دين الله إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر وليشهد عذابهما طائفة من المؤمنين الزاني لا ينكح إلا زانية أو مشركة والزانية لا ينكحها إلا زان أو مشرك وحرم ذلك على المؤمنين والذين يرمون المحصنات ثم لم يأتوا بأربعة شهداء فاجلدوهم ثمانين جلدة ولا تقبلوا لهم شهادة أبدا وأولئك هم الفاسقون إلا الذين تابوا من بعد ذلك وأصلحوا فإن الله غفور رحيم والذين يرمون أزواجهم ولم يكن لهم شهداء إلا أنفسهم فشهادة أحدهم أربع شهادات بالله إنه لمن الصادقين.
As for the fornicatress and the fornicator, that is, of those not in wedlock, because those, in wedlock, are stoned according to the Sunnah, the Al, in Al-Zaniya, the fornicatress, and Al-Zani, the fornicator, according to some mentioned, opinions, is a relative, particle, the clause, al-zaniyatu wal-zani, is a subject, and because of its similarity to a conditional, the fa, has been inserted into the predicate, which is, the following, fajlidu, strike each of them 100 lashes, 100, strikes, one says jaladahu to mean daraba jildahu, he struck him on the skin. According to the sunnah, in addition to this, punishment, there is also banishment for a whole year. The slave, however, receives half of the mentioned punishment. And do not let any pity for them overcome you in God's religion, that is to say, in the fulfillment of His rulings, by disregarding any part of their prescribed punishment, if you believe in God in the last day, namely, the day of resurrection. In this statement, there is an incitement to abide by what was mentioned before the conditional, above, and it also constitutes the response to the latter, or, at least is, an indication of the response to it. And let their punishment, the flogging, be witnessed by a group of the believers, some say, that this should be a group of, three, some say four, as in the number of witnesses testifying to an act of fornication.
والخامسة أن لعنة الله عليه إن كان من الكاذبين ويدرأ عنها العذاب أن تشهد أربع شهادات بالله إنه لمن الكاذبين والخامسة أن غضب الله عليها إن كان من الصادقين ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته وأن الله تواب حكيم إن الذين جاءوا بالإفك عصبة منكم لا تحسبوه شرا لكم بل هو خير لكم لكل امرئ منهم ما اكتسب من الإثم والذي تولى كبره منهم له عذاب عظيم لولا إذ سمعتموه ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا وقالوا هذا إفك مبين لولا جاءوا عليه بأربعة شهداء فإذ لم يأتوا بالشهداء فأولئك عند الله هم الكاذبون ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته في الدنيا والآخرة لمسكم فيما أفضتم فيه عذاب عظيم.
الله.
The fornicator shall not marry anyone but a fornicatress or an idolatress, and the fornicatress shall be married by none except a fornicator or an idolater, in other words, what is suitable for each of the two, for the purposes of marriage, is the above mentioned, and that, namely, marrying of fornicators, is forbidden to believers, who are better than those. This was revealed when the poor among the emigrants resolved to marry the wealthy whores of the idolaters, so that they, the women, would provide for them. Thus it is said that the prohibition applies specifically to them, but it is also said to apply in general, but it was abrogated by God's words, marry off the spouseless among you. 24-32 Quetzales.